Tips for Giving Medical Expert Testimony by Dr. Sandeep Narang.
The one thing to remember, and which we frequently lose sight of, is that with regards to medical information that's going to be presented in the courtroom, you are the most knowledgeable person in that courtroom. You are the one that nobody is going to be able to question with regards to that. So hopefully that'll provide some solace as you start getting in there to ready to be testified. But based upon that, in trying to make sure that you are that person or supposed to be that person who has the greatest portion of medical expertise, you have to know the medical facts of that particular case cold. It shouldn't be something that you have to then flum through your report, because then that makes you seem like somebody who is really not attentive to the importance of the case. So that's an important thing you can do, and as well as knowing the pertinent medical literature very well. That's something that comes easy to many physicians, but it's always good to review before you get in to court, and I'm sure the anxiety will help provoke that as well. The other thing is, when feasible, and I know that's not always feasible in some of our inquisitorial court systems, is to know the purpose of your examination if you're not the court-appointed expert, okay? In our adversarial system, we frequently get told that by the party that's asking us to either render a report or to come testify, and to know whether you have the entire case or limited facts, okay? Also, when you're thinking about testifying, it's always good and always sometimes not possible in the inquisitorial system, but always good to try and be prepared to testify without prompting. So you should be able to testify as if you're having a conversation with the person who is asking you the questions. It should flow smoothly. It shouldn't seem like there's great gaps or things like that. And then always, this is the most important thing, is when you are in there and you are actually testifying, just listen to the question that's asked. Take a breath, listen to the question that's asked, and only answer that question. Don't think about potentialities, don't think about hypotheticals, don't try and answer things that aren't being asked, because nothing loses or, one, upsets in our adversarial system a judge more, or loses a fact finder more when you start pontificating and going off on tangents. And just like in basic conversation, when answering, speak to the appropriate fact finder. If it's in the inquisitorial system, speak to the judge. If it's in our adversarial system, turn and speak to the jury. And finally, because you are walking in there, presumably with the persona of a well-respected physician, maintain that persona. So don't be argumentative. Don't be flippant. Don't be arrogant. Be a kind, knowledgeable physician that you are. Maintain that persona. It's very difficult in our adversarial systems when the bullets start firing and you get a lot of the very adversarial or confrontational questions, but it's important to remember who you are as the impartial reviewer of facts and educator to the court, and answer accordingly.